where you will be writing your scripts for doing various functions. The second one is this tab. Okay, so here you will be having your scripts, whatever projects you have done, whatever code you have written. Okay, so you can find it. So hello friends, welcome back to your channel. Today I would be showing you about why to use, first of all, Google Earth Engine, and how to sign up in it and how to make an account, first of all, to use it. So first of all, let me tell you why to use the Google Earth Engine. So let's get into the system and talk. First of all, search the Google Earth Engine. Okay, Google Earth Engine. So the Google Earth Engine is mostly for the cloud computing, the remote sensing data. So most of the time, when you don't have a fast internet connection, when you don't have a very high speed internet connection, and you need to download gigabytes of data and process in it your system, so it is not quite possible sometimes due to the less poor or poor internet connections. So in that time, the Google Earth Engines come to your help. And so the Google Earth Engine just provides you the available data you want and process it in its cloud and just give you the result of what you want. Okay, so you can download it in your system and just use it for a further analysis also. So that's first of all why we use Google Earth Engine in most of the traditional remote sensing cases, like we were using the ADAS engine and the NV and the snaps. So all this which we were using are can be done in the same in the Google Earth Engine also. So let's get started with the making an account in first in Google Earth Engine. So just type in like code. First of all, just enter over here Google Earth Engine. So you can see over here the sign up button. Okay, so you can sign up by your Google account. It's a simple process, friends. You can do it, and make sure you give enough of all your information, like why you want to use the Google Earth Engine, and what profession you are. If you're a student, if you're working in an organization, give the name of the organization and for what purpose you want to use it. So give enough information so that the Google approves your account as early as possible and you can use it. Okay, now as I'm having my Google Earth Engine account, so I will just step into that directly. So this is the Google Earth Engine. This is the website of like code.earthengine.com, google.com. okay, so here you will be having four tabs. Okay, the first one is the code editor, where you will be writing your scripts for doing various functions. The second one is this tab. Okay, so here you will be having your scripts, whatever projects you have done, whatever code you have written. Okay, so you can find it over here, your scripts. Okay, now the docs. So here you can see most of the algorithms which are already helpful, like for the tutorials I will be using the image collection. This EE means the Earth Engine. Okay, so most of the time we would be using geometry, image collection, and yes, for exporting the data, that is also an export. Okay, so most of the times we will be using this, but you can explore this, all this. Okay, now there is also an option in the Earth Engine for the import your data. Okay, so you can import your data also over here, like most of the time you can also we will be using the shape files as an import option, because it is less heavy and less size also. CSV files we can also add it over here. There is an option of GeoTIFF, adding mostly the raster images also, so we can add that also. But it's upon you. It's up to you. Okay. Now there is an remote tab also over here, where you would be having the consoles, the tasks, and like most of the time, if you have done some coding, you will be familiar with the consoles and the inspector, all these things. So if you are not, don't worry. We would be using as much as less coding, some basic types of coding, which is involved and which is useful for get our work done. Okay. So now this is the tab where we would be having most of the things shown in over here. So as we write the code over here and run it, we can see the processes done over here. So it's the default in the United States. Let's get into India. Okay, so this is our lovely India. Now here there are several tabs where we can add the marker, we can draw a line, we can have a shape file, polygon, and draw a rectangle ourselves. Okay, so this is the thing. And also we can get into the map, into terrain also, like as we do in the Google Earth. Okay, so if you want to see the labels also, the so all the systems are available in the Google Earth engine. Now if we get into this tab, okay, so here you can see there are several options: the developer discussion groups, question answer sites. Okay, so there is also general shortcuts, which I think you should be knowing, like for the saving a script. If you have written a code and you want to save it, definitely you will be saving it. So you can use the Control plus S. Okay, so these are some keyboard shortcuts. Most of the times I would be I like to use the commenting down for Control and forward slash, and for running a script I mostly use where it is. Yeah, Control and Enter. Yeah, so we can just run the scripts also from Control and Enter. So these are the most of the shortcuts we which I use, and which you will also be using. So that's why I've shown you. So that's it for today, guys. In the next video, I would show you some basic applications also, and what amount of data sets present in the Google Earth engine, and how you can use it, and also get started with the first program. So that's it for today, guys. In the next video, I will be talking about the data sets that Google Earth engine provide, and how should we analyze it, process it, and download it. So make sure you subscribe the button, and we will see you next time.